to you. And I appreciate you coming up here. And no matter what we talk about today, okay, when you're done talking to me, then you'll be going back to wherever you need to go, okay? So I appreciate that. Now, I know it's a little warm in here, so I apologize for that. It's just kind of an older building. There was just a couple things I wanted to kind of talk to you about. And I guess it's a little bit of it was, that, remember when I talked to you the other day, I think it was like,
in your car.
Like 2 weeks ago, Thursday or something like that?
Yeah.
Or last week?
I remember.
I'm so old, I can't remember stuff.
I don't know when it was, but.
And I'd ask you about what you told Detective Maroney at the school that day. And then you were kind of telling me something a little bit different about where you spent the night at and who you were with and all that. And so I just want you to kind of listen to the two stories you gave, and we'll work through that and see what the real story is, okay? So let's just listen to this here real quick, that way you can remember what you said. Now, this is not my recorder, so I'm not sure. And just real quick, this isn't the whole interview, it's just the two segments that I'm concerned about, where you told her you were that night and where you told me you were that night. So it's not like the whole interview, so it's just going to be a minute or two long.
And were you at home last night, I guess, when your parents were having the barbecue? And
yeah.
I remember there. Okay. And then what?
I was going to sleep, and so was he.
Okay. About what time was that?
I'm not sure. After we got done eating, I was wore out from school, so
yeah.
We were both going to sleep.
Okay. And does he change into pajamas, or does he sleep in his clothes?
Yeah.
Okay. Did he say anything to you about? Okay.
I would think that your first story that you told Detective Maroney at the school is probably the true version of the events, because Cassie says she doesn't remember if you stayed there or not that night.
John does.
No, John doesn't either.
Because he was passed out on the couch.
I'm just telling you. So, we need to get work through what the truth really is, okay? Like I say, you're leaving here. When you're done talking to me, or you can get it, walk out right now. But so we kind of need to get the truth. And there's a lot of other things I want to talk to you about. So let's kind of work through this part at first. Tell me the truth about that night.
We were on the back porch. It was me, him, Dad, and Amanda. Dad and Amanda stayed on that porch the whole night, evidently, because we were on the back porch and he told me he was going to take a shower and calm down for the night. So I went to Cassie's. I didn't know if I was going to sleep down there or sleep down at Amanda's, but I got comfortable down at Cassie's, ended up watching a movie and falling asleep down there.
So why would you?
I guess the first day, it was a bad day.
Yeah, and I can understand that. But let me tell you this. I had a family member murdered before. And when I told the police, back when I was like 11, I told them the truth the first time. I didn't have to tell them something that I know. I was upset and I was scared and I was angry and I was all those things that everybody went through. But I still told the police, when they asked me a question, I would tell them what happened. They didn't have to come back to me a week later or 2 weeks later or a month later, because what I told them was the truth. So when you start telling a couple different stories, it makes me wonder about your credibility or your truthfulness. And at this point, I believe the story you told her at the school that day is the true story. Because even Amanda said you were there.
That night?
That night when he was taking a shower.
No, I wasn't. You can ask my dad.
I mean, but
you can ask.
But the stories aren't even, well, your stories aren't even close to I wasn't there. I was down at Cassie's watching TV, getting comfortable. To, I was there, I saw him take a shower, we were going to go to bed, I saw him put his clothes back on, including his shoes.
But I got that story because my dad and Amanda told me that night he walked out the back door fully dressed head to toe and then walked back in and shut the door.
And of course I think that's easy to say now, but she clarified with you a couple of different times. So you saw him put his clothes back on?
Yes.
What kind of shoes did he put on? Some kind of black shoes. It's not like my dad told me, or it's not like Amanda told me.
I mean, that's
or
the only kind of shoes he had, that had to be the shoes he put back on.
Okay, but you see what I'm saying? That your story doesn't make any sense. And I don't want you to get jammed up in this murder case at all.
I don't have nothing to do with it.
And so that's kind of where we need to work through right now before we go on to some other things. I think you were in the house that night. I think you saw him take a shower. I think you saw him put his clothes back on. And I think you, him, and your dad went back down to where this happened at.
No, sir.
And let me just show you my phone here real quick. See on my phone? A lot of people have these nowadays. It's got a voice recorder on it. And we can record. And I can talk and say, "Chop, you know, hello, how are you doing, Josh Young?" And I can stop it. And I can save it, and then I can play it.
I can talk, play chop, and hello, how are you doing, Josh Young?
See how that works? And you would never know if that was on my, you'd never know if this was sitting right here, would you? That I was recording our conversation. You would have no idea. So you have talked to a few people that were smart enough to do something similar to this, either with their phone or with a little digital recorder or something like that. And I know you've talked to a few people. I don't mean police-wise, I mean friends. Some of your friends you've talked to. And you've told your friends a few things, a little more in detail about maybe what happened to Trey. Yeah?
Like what?
And I've got a text message from some of your friends that they were sending to their other friends, telling them what you had told them.
Well, I've told you the truth.
What have you told Connor? Who's some of your other close friends?
After that incident, nobody was really able to come back around.
Okay, but who? Just because they don't come around after the murder. still got, there's still people you never were acquaintances with, or?
I was pretty cool with everybody on the street. Everybody was always down there, Cassie's, Amanda's.
What other female friends do you have or do you associate with?
Not really any.
Who's Connor been arguing with on Facebook?
Sarah.
Have you talked to Sarah?
Not recently, no.
I mean, before the murder, a couple days after the murder?
Maybe.
Think about what I just showed you on my phone, or what we talked about. I want you to tell me the truth about what you and Sarah might have talked about.
I can't remember if I've talked to Sarah or not after. I know I've talked to her before.
Right.
But.
And what was y'all's conversations about Trey?
None. She didn't know anything about Trey that I knew of.
She knew Trey.
She did? I didn't know that. She never came around.
What other girls do you have that were friends of yours?
Not really any. Sarah's not even a friend. I don't talk to her anymore because Connor and her don't get along. So I haven't talked to her at all.
So why would there be other friends out there that have came to me and I've interviewed more people in this case than probably any murder case that I've interviewed anybody on, even the Little Ivan Kano case? Why would some of your friends, male or female, come to me and say that you and your dad were talking about how you all would kill people before Trey was murdered, and that Trey was murdered in a similar fashion to how you described how you and your dad would do it?
I have no idea.
So why would they lie about that?
Grudges? I don't know. I get along with everybody.
So if I had a grudge with...
So nobody would really have a reason to lie.
Like, to say that CPS worker, Bridget. Say I had a grudge with her.
Well, Bridget.
Yeah, that's just one, you know. So if I had a grudge with her for any reason, some kind of work issue, you think I would go around saying, Bridget told me that her and her mom were going to talk about how they were going to kill somebody.
I know what you're
saying. And then, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's a horrible thing. Maybe for credit.
It'd be
maybe
something different on a grudge. You could be like, you know.
Maybe to be noticed. I don't know.
Were you talking about stuff like that, maybe to be noticed?
No. I never once talked about killing anybody. And I never heard my dad talking about killing anybody. And my dad liked Trey, and so did I.
Okay, let's talk about the ride down. Why did y'all go to Alabama? What was the reason to pick Alabama?
We were just passing through Alabama.
What made you all even leave? The girl that was with you, who's she?
Sister Friend.
Had you met her before?
Huh?
Had you met her before?
Yeah, I've known her.
I mean, because obviously your dad is on parole, so he's not allowed to even leave this county. And I know a few weeks ago y'all went to Michigan. And then y'all went to Alabama. So what was the conversation in the car? And going down to Alabama, y'all driving in the car, with some of the conversation y'all had?
Can't even remember.
And I'm specifically talking about just the incident with Trey.
I don't even know if we talked to Trey about Trey on the way to Alabama.
Well, you all talked about it. Because she did the same thing. She knew that your dad might be a little... She's not sure if she could trust him all the way, so she recorded some of y'all's conversations.
I don't believe that, because we didn't talk about Trey on the way to Alabama.
So why would I hear on the recording that you all were talking about, you specifically talking about, you were kicking Trey in the head?
I don't know. That didn't happen. I never have said that in my life.
Okay, so your friends that say you are talking about killing people a couple weeks before the murder, and Trey dies similarly, and this girl driving to Alabama, she's lying, so everybody's just lying.
That's not true at all.
So they're all just liars?
I don't know what they are. They aren't telling the truth, so it must make them liars.
Have you had a chance to think about, obviously, I mean, your life was pretty good while your dad was in prison, you gotta admit. You had a much better situation.
I mean, I love my dad more than anybody in this world, and I'd rather be with him than anybody in this world. So my life was much better with my dad.
So your life was better getting arrested in Alabama?
Being with my dad, it's all worth it.
Really? So you would rather not be in a secure home, having a secure school,
if I'm with my dad,
having a decent family, having Trey as your friend? Now he gets out of jail, or he gets out of prison, and Amanda quits her job, he goes to jail, Trey gets murdered. I mean, all that stuff's better. That's better to you?
Of course not. I said being with my dad is better than being anywhere else.
You've been with your dad for, he's been out for what, 7 months, something like that?
About that.
And you've already been arrested in Alabama for a gun charge? That's better? I'm confused by that statement.
I had nothing to do with it.
Well, obviously you did, because they released you and the charges were dismissed.
So that was just accidental arrest. They had no reason to arrest me.
Well, there was a gun in the room, and nobody had a permit to have it, so that's their city ordinance, so it's not an accidental arrest.
I mean, they could. I don't mess with my guns. I'm 15, and I look like having a gun.
Well, and you don't think I've arrested 15-year-olds for carrying guns before?
I'm sure you have.
Okay, so then... that just doesn't make sense, but...
it does to me.
So, I mean, there's just a lot of inconsistencies in your story, and that's what I'm concerned about. Either it was how you saw him or when you didn't see him, or you talked about killing people and then you didn't talk about killing people, or you
talked about
kicking him in the head and then you didn't talk about kicking him. I mean, it just seems like everybody's, I just said that 5 minutes
ago.
It seems like everybody's telling me stuff, and to you, everything's like, no, nothing happened, they're liars, I don't know what you're talking about.
I've never said anything like that. Neither is my dad or anybody.
Do you know much about... I'm sure you probably watch like CSIs and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah. I like Law and Order, but CSIs are alright.
A little more cheesy, isn't it?
It's alright.
And then, how well do you know the girl in Michigan?
Nikki. I know her. I mean, we started talking on Facebook while my dad was in prison, but...
How old is she?
How old is she?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I mean, is she like 20 or is she like 40 or 10?
I guess around my dad's age. Probably. I'm not sure.
What was the situation there with him and her?
They were arguing over her talking to somebody or something, I don't know. But
were you there, I guess, when he supposedly put a knife to her throat and all that?
Mm-hmm.
Where were you at when that happened, supposedly?
I didn't know that happened at all. So I can't answer that question.
Well, I mean, did he ever go up there recently without you? I know you all went once.
No.
And then how did you all get up to Michigan?
This last time?
Yeah.
My sister's mom.
What sister?
Sister in Michigan.
Okay. She drove all the way down here to get you?
Well, she stayed down there a little bit too for a day.
Oh, okay. How'd y'all get to Alabama?
I don't feel comfortable answering that question.
Have you heard about Alabama? Today.
Yeah. I mean, I don't
know. Did you hitchhike or did you take a plane? Or that's all I'm asking. Did you take a train?
No. We drove.
Did that girl have a car?
Uh-uh.
Oh. So what's the deal with that lady down there?
I don't want to talk. I ain't in that. I don't feel comfortable talking about that. I had nothing to do with anything about that. So I don't feel the need to talk about it.
Okay, going back to the forensic stuff. Some people said that your dad... And I have phone records to verify it. Said that your dad talked to somebody, and I'm not going to tell you who, at about 9:37 on that Tuesday night y'all had the cookout. And he said that he was with you, and your dad said that he was with Trey, and y'all were all smoking weed. And I'm not worried about it if you are, because I ain't the police, I don't care about that. I'm just going to tell you what the story is so you know what I'm talking about. And this was at 9:37. And the toxicology results for Trey after the autopsy was he had marijuana in his urine but not in his blood, which means it was in the system just quickly enough to get in his urine
before he
was killed.
No, he smokes weed just as much as anybody else. If he has weed in his system, it's in his blood.
It's not in his blood.
It's an everyday thing.
It's in his urine only. It did not show up in his blood.
Well, he was at his dad's previously before that on ground.
So if your dad is saying he's with you and Trey smoking weed at 9:37,
he said that.
Okay, well he did at 9:37, and I plus have phone records to verify the person's story that told me this. And so at 9:37, he's saying he's with you and Trey smoking weed, and then Trey doesn't have enough weed in the system to get into his blood, which means he was murdered pretty fast after that phone call.
Mm-hmm. I was at Cassie's.
Well, you weren't at Cassie's.
I was.
No.
With John. John was on the couch. She was waking up, nodding back up.
You may have been there at some point. But you weren't there. You were there maybe after Josh took a shower, or Trey took a shower, and Trey got dressed, and Trey tried to leave, and Trey put his shoes back on. Because I know you saw all that. Okay, so if your story is you didn't see him take a shower, you all weren't getting ready to go to bed, you didn't see him put his shoes back on or his clothes back on, then how can I believe anything else you tell me during this whole entire interview? Because you clearly said it. I mean, I can play it again if you want to hear it. I can play it again.
I heard everything on the CD.
I mean, I can play it again.
You don't have to trust me. I mean, you don't know me.
I mean, if you're lying about that, then how do I know you're telling me the truth about anything else?
That's just a chance you have to take. All right. Really, anyway.
Have you talked to Amanda or seen Amanda? And then I guess Connor came and visited you yesterday or day before or something?
Yesterday, day before.
How did that go? What was that conversation about?
Nothing about Trey or anything that's going on legal-wise. Me, her, and her mom played a board game. Just hung out for a little bit. We didn't get the full visit because her grandma brought her down and her grandma wasn't on the list. She couldn't stay alone, so she had to, I guess, go back home and get her mom to bring her. So it was a short visit, period.
I mean, but you see how all the information I'm getting from a lot of different people, from phone records, from autopsy reports.
I can tell you I've never once talked about killing anybody, kicking Trey in the head. Me, Trey, and my dad were not smoking weed at 9:37. That's all false.
I mean, you see why I would have to come back and talk to you about that.
I would talk to somebody about that. If I had your job, I'd be doing the same thing, and I understand why you're doing it, but I have nothing to do with it, and I'm pretty sure my dad doesn't either. My dad is with Amanda. She stated that the whole night. Why would she try to change it? Is she trying to change that now?
Well, I'm not going to tell you who's changing what or who's talking about what. That's part of the investigation. So have you had time to think about what might have happened down there that night?
I mean, it's just blank in my head. Everybody's thought about it. I don't know what could have possibly happened.
My feeling is you know more than what you're telling me.
That's not true.
And my feeling is, did you know your dad tried to call me twice yesterday?
Mm-mm.
And that he called me when y'all got locked up to let me know y'all got locked up? I mean, you want to find the person responsible for this, right?
Well, of course. What kind of question is that? Yeah, I do.
That's the question I'm asking. That's the kind
of
question.
As much of anybody else, yes.
So your honesty is important in this investigation.
I understand that, and I've told you I have nothing to do with it. Neither does my dad. That's why are you harassing us and the close family instead of really trying to figure out?
Oh. I've heard so people you know, say that. So you know what I've done in my investigation?
I mean, you've been harassing my dad, so has everybody else.
How have I harassed your dad? Your dad calls me like 20 times a day.
I mean,
wait. You're going to sit there with your hat all cocked sideways, with your red that your dad likes to wear and all that stuff, and your red shorts hanging down, your underwear sticking out, but you're going to tell me things that you have no idea about.
Well, I just don't.
I have not harassed your dad.
I feel
your
like
dad called me 10 times a day. Your dad's called me twice since he's been locked up in Alabama. He's called me twice, so I'm harassing your dad. So you're just gonna, you can sit there and say stuff that you don't know what you're talking about.
Who else have I
interviewed in this case?
I have no idea.
You don't know who I've interviewed in this case.
I'm talking about me and my father.
Right, but you said I need to be doing stuff to find out who really did it. But you don't know what
Instead
I did.
Instead of interviewing me.
So to sit there and just run your mouth is
Amanda,
pretty inappropriate.
Well, I'm sorry for
You should be sorry.
But I didn't mean it that way. I just meant
how do you mean it when I say you said
I'm
harassing
you? I think it's an inconvenience that you're interviewing me right now and I don't know anything.
Okay, but you just said 10 minutes ago that if you had my job, you would ask me the same question.
Yeah, but not keep on going and going and saying that you think I know more than I'm saying, which I don't. I think that's harassment. That's calling me a liar.
And I think I can play it again if you want to hear your statement.
I told you.
Which, to me, you're a liar.
Well,
I mean, your own word. It's your own words. You can't take back your own words. Your own words were, you saw him take a, you knew he was taking a shower. You were going to go to bed. You never once told Detective Roney that you were going to go down and stay at Cassie's house. You told her you all were preparing to go to bed. And that he took a shower. You watched him put his clothes back on. You watched him put his shoes back on. Those are your own words, not my words, not her words. You can't take back your words. Those are on tape. And that's, I believe what it is, just a story.
It's the truth.
Okay, so then it must be the truth that you saw him put his clothes back on and take a shower.
No, I knew he put his clothes back on and his shoes back on, and they must have been the black shoes because the only shoes he wore.
But that's not what you told her.
Well,
it wasn't because you heard
I wasn't shocked that day. I was. Along with everybody else.
Do you have any questions of me?
Do you know anything about my dad? What's going on with him right now?
Mm-hmm.
Me neither. That's pretty much it.
So let me ask you this. If it came down to your dad saying he had an involvement or your dad saying you had an involvement, which choice do you think he'd pick?
It's neither.
You think he would go to prison for it?
He's innocent and so am I. There's no reason either one of us should be going to prison.
Well, I mean, I hope you're telling me the truth, because I mean, obviously some of the things, I know you're not telling me the truth on, for things I've heard with my own ears on the recordings and the things I've heard you say with your own words.
Okay.
I know it's not the truth. And that's why I'm giving you this last opportunity to tell me the truth. Can you sit here long enough for me to let get your worker to come back up here?
Yeah.
I'll have him walk up. That way he can walk up with you.
Is that woman?
No, no, the guy that you were here with.
Ah, I thought you meant my social worker, Allison.
She may be here. I have to go check. I'm just going to pull this door shut and just tell your worker.